Hi, my name is Nate Alvarado. Welcome to this week's Extreme Science featuring the one and only geek, Pete Miller, basketball extraordinaire. We'll be here at Myers Sports Complex with the one and only basketball extraordinaire, Pete Miller. Follow me as we head into the gym. So this week, we're gonna be featuring Pete's specialty shot, the full court shot. Now, no one else in the world can do this, and we don't know how this Pete Miller guy can do it, but man, if you thought his dress was extreme, wait till you see this shot. He doesn't know we're coming, so we're gonna have to keep a soft voice as we enter the gym. As you can see, our newly renovated Trinity Myers gym here. Coming up, he should just be practicing. I don't know exactly what he'll be practicing in this very instant, but we're coming in, and we need to approach it like Steve Irwin, okay? I want you to get in that mindset. Like, we're going in for the kill. We're trying to get that crocodile or that stingray, whatever it is, and we need to sneak up, but let's not get hurt. All right, now we're gonna call Pete over and we're gonna see if we can get a nice little interview, figure out exactly the science behind this full court shot of his. Hey Pete, why don't you come on over?
What's up?
How you doing, Pete?
I'm doing great, how are you?
It's good to see you.
Thanks for having me on here, thank you.
No problem. So, we know that you are the basketball extraordinaire. You're the king of basketball. And you may not look the part, but you sure play the part. But we're here, as you know, in this week's Extreme Sports to find out how you do this full court shot. How do you do it?
Well, it's very simple, really. Just get it and throw it. Wanna watch?
Yeah, let's get this footage. Let's get this footage. This is... no one has ever got this before. Let's see this. He's just gonna get it and throw it. Wow, Pete, that was amazing. I don't know how you did that, but oh my goodness. Any explanations here? I mean, frankly, I'm stunned. I don't know.
Just your talent. I thought that was amazing. Watch this.
Holy cow! Now let's check out that last one from a scientific perspective. All right, welcome backstage to the office back here. What we're gonna do is break down Pete Miller's last jump shot. And we have three questions. The first one that we need to answer is, how fast did Pete release the ball? When he got up and released it, how fast did it come? The velocity there, we need to figure out. The second question is, how high did that ball travel? At the apex, how high was that ball? The third and last question was, how fast did the ball arrive at the rim? So, to figure these questions out, we have three equations of constant acceleration. Our first equation is here, second and third, and I will break them down further as we go along. All right, let's get started on this equation. We have the final velocity equals the initial velocity plus acceleration times time. So our final velocity for this equation will be the apex, which means there's no velocity, so it is at zero. We're solving for the initial velocity. The acceleration will be the gravity, and that is in feet, so it's negative 32.2. The time it took to make the shot was 2.25 seconds. Half of that, since we're solving for the first half of the problem, is 1.125 seconds. So negative 32.2 times 1.125. We fill in and we do the math here. We have a 0 equals VI minus 36.23. We bring this 36 here, and we get an initial velocity of 36.23 feet per second. So that is an amazing shot speed at 36.23 feet per second. All right, second equation is ready. We got the final position is equal to the initial position plus the initial velocity times the time plus half of the acceleration times the time. Now, we have the initial velocity, it was at 36.23 feet per second. We have the acceleration, we have the time. We are solving for the final position. We need to know what this apex is. Pete Miller is 6 feet tall. He shot the ball a foot above his top height, which makes him at 7 feet at a release point. So SF equals 7 plus 36.23 times 1.125 plus half of 32.2 times 1.125. Plug everything in, and once again, this acceleration is negative. We plug everything in, and we get a final position, this apex. Amazing height here. He shot with some just unbelievable arc. It's at 68.14 feet. So that is our top line. All right, now for our last equation, we have final velocity squared equals the initial velocity squared plus 2 times the acceleration, and in parentheses, we have final position minus the initial position. So our initial velocity is the apex. So we know at the apex there's zero velocity there. So it is zero. We know our acceleration is 32.2, and that's a negative. Our final position is at 10 feet. That is the height of the basket. Our initial position is at the top of this apex, what we just figured out in equation 2, and that was 68.14 feet equals final velocity squared. We plug all this in, and then we will have to square root this final answer because we need to get VF by itself, and we get a final velocity of 61.19 feet per second. So that ball is coming in hot to the rim. Once again, 61.19 feet per second. All right, let's wrap up everything that we just found. First question was, how fast did Pete Miller release that ball? That velocity was 36.23 feet per second. Second question that we had was, at the apex, how high did that ball travel? That was 68.14 feet at the highest point. Last question was, how fast did that ball arrive at the rim? And we determined that it was coming in smoking hot at 61.19 feet per second. All right, let's head back to the gym. So that wraps us up on the sports side of Mr. Pete Miller's full court shot. You know, that was amazing. He threw the ball at a nice angle. It was greater than 45 degrees as we went over. The time that it took to get there, the acceleration, the velocity, everything was there. Amazing.
That's right. Hey, kid.
Thanks, Pete Miller.
Just get it and throw it.
Okay.
Amazing. It really does work. You just catch and throw. Well, looks like I still got some work to do.
You're thinking too much, kid. LeBron James has nothing on this.
Tune in next week as we interview sensational runner Josh Run Till I Die Thomas, and as we break down VO2 max and the science of running a marathon. See you next time.
Goes in every time.
Tune in next week for our special sneak preview of Josh. Tune in next week as we have.
Your hands are wet.
Oh. All right. Okay. I gotta say something. Something's rigged here. Okay. Cause this joke, Miller. Okay. This apex 68.14 feet. Myers is only like 40 feet high, maybe 50. I mean, what the heck? Did it go through the roof when I wasn't looking?